morning, everyone. I'm thankful to the Virology Committee to give me this opportunity to be here. And it's my pleasure to give a talk on HIV and other retroviral diseases and its related oral infections in Afro-Asian countries. Based on the UNAIDS global AIDS epidemic, estimated 35 million HIV patients are worldwide. Out of that, 5.6 million HIV people are living in South Africa. 97% of them are living in low and middle-income countries, particularly in sub-Saharan Africa. Approximately 4.7 million people were living with HIV in 2008. This is the mode of transmission. The greatest mode of transmission is seen among the heterosexuals, about 87.1%, followed by the parent to child, then the homosexual transmission, injecting drug users, blood-to-blood products, and unknown factors. HTLV-1, or human T-cell lymphotropic virus type 1, it is the first RNA virus discovered in 1981. About 15 to 20 million HTLV type 1 infected patients are found worldwide. Africa, East and Central Asia are probably the largest endemic area of the disease. An association was found between the infection and a reduced salivary flow in the mouth, leading to several of the dental diseases, which will be discussed later on. HIV and oral diseases. Your mouth may be the first part of your body to show a sign of HIV infection. The more the virus being produced in the body, the rapidly the disease progresses. Oral lesions reflect the stages of immunosuppression. About 30 to 80% of the affected population might show some signs of oral infection in the mouth. Staging of HIV, more than CD4 count, about 600 is a normal count. Less than 500 shows with the initial immune suppression. CD4 count less than 400 starts with the oral lesions that may appear in the mouth. CD4 count between 200 and 400 shows an increased severity and number of opportunistic infections in the mouth and the progression of the oral lesions. Less than 200 CD4 count shows AIDS, severe immune suppression. HIV and oral diseases can be grouped into the following: infections, fungal, viral, bacterial, neoplasms or oral malignancies, Kaposi's sarcoma, non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Immune-mediated are aphthous stomatitis, necrotizing stomatitis. Others are related to the salivary gland disorders, parotid diseases, and xerostomia. Fungal infections, candidiasis, erythematous candidiasis. It appears when the CD4 count falls below 300. The lesion appears as red, flat, subtle lesion, either on the hard or the soft palate, or on the dorsal surface of the tongue. The patient may complain of severe burning sensation in the mouth while taking any spicy or salty food. Pseudomembranous candidiasis. The lesion appears as creamy white curd-like blocks on the buccal mucosa and on the tongue. The characteristic feature of the lesion is that the lesion can be wiped away or scraped off, leaving a red or bleeding surface. Hyperplastic or chronic candidiasis. The lesion appears similar to the above one, showing white plaques over the mucosal surface of the entire oral mucosa. But the lesion is non-removable. It cannot be scraped away or wiped off. Ancular colitis. It appears as an erythema or fissuring or cracks at the corners of the mouth. It occurs with or without the presence of candidal infections like erythematous candidiasis or pseudomembranous candidiasis. Viral infections. Oral hairy leukoplakia is caused by the Epstein-Barr virus. It's seen when the CD4 counts falls below 200. Study says that the oral hairy leukoplakia lesion commonly seen among heterosexuals. The lesion appears bilaterally on the tongue and is asymptomatic. It appears as vertical white striations or as flat or raised shaggy plaques with the hair-like keratin projections on the tongue. Herpes simplex virus infections caused by the herpes simplex virus. It appears as a clusters of painful small vesicles that ruptures and it ulcerates, and usually it heals within 7 to 10 days. The virus is responsible for the primary and the secondary activation of the oral lesions, and the common site are the oral mucosa, the palate, dorsum of the tongue, and the gingiva. Study says that recurrent herpes simplex infections are more common among the patients with symptomatic HIV disease. Cytomegalovirus infections are caused by the cytomegalovirus. It is seen in advanced stage when the CD4 count falls below 50. Patient complains of painful ulcerations of the gingiva or the gum area and the tongue. It's associated with the salivary gland disorders, causes enlargement of the parotid glands and submandibular salivary gland, causing a reduced salivary flow in the mouth, resulting in dry mouth. Human papillomavirus infections caused by the human papillomavirus. It is seen as either pedunculate or sessile oral warts with a papillomatous appearance. It's a picture of the child showing a oral wart lesion on the labial commissures of the mouth. The common site are the palate, buccal mucosa, and the labial commissures. The immune suppression in HIV-infected individuals results in the reactivation of the herpes virus. It can lead to several of the HIV-associated periodontal disease. Higher frequency of cytomegalovirus and Epstein-Barr virus were detected in subgingival plaque samples or the plaque samples collected from deep inside the gingiva. It is seen in high HIV-positive individuals with periodontal disease than in HIV-negative individuals. Bacterial infections is a chronic inflammatory periodontal disease. Initial lesion is the chronic gingivitis. It causes the inflammation of the gingiva or the gum area. It involves either the gram-positive or the gram-negative microorganisms. It's a picture of the tooth showing, a part of the tooth showing a healthy part, another part affected with the periodontal disease. The healthy part shows an intact gum area around the tooth, an intact level of bone and periodontal ligament that holds the tooth in place. When the tooth is affected with the periodontal disease, you can red and inflamed gums that is due to the tartar or the dental plaque attached to the tooth, causing severe bone loss around the tooth. That is the periodontal instrument showing a deep probing. The deeper the probe goes in, the higher the loss of attachment or higher the loss of bone around the tooth. And that stage is known as the chronic periodontitis. It causes the destruction of the periodontium around the tooth, resulting in the mobility of the tooth and eventually the tooth loss. It consists of predominantly of gram-negative bacteria. The primary etiology of the disease is dental plaque, consisting of at least 800 bacterial species. Acute necrotizing ulcerative gingivitis, or ANUG, is a severe form of chronic gingivitis. It appears when the CD4 count falls below 200. The oral lesion appears as painful, punched-out, crater-like depressions on the crest of the interdental papillae or around the gingival margins. It has a rapid onset, but it resolves quickly with a mechanical debridement or with a good mouthwash, chloroxidine mouthwash. If the ANUG is not treated immediately, it leads to acute necrotizing ulcerative periodontitis or ANUP. It is a severe form of chronic periodontitis. There's painful ulceration and necrosis of the interdental papillae around the gingival margins. The periodontal destruction can lead to the loss of bone around the tooth, eventually tooth mobility and tooth loss. If ANUG and ANUP are not treated immediately, it can lead to the most severe condition, acute necrotizing stomatitis. Here, there is extension of the necrosis past the periodontium into the oral mucosa, and the osseous tissue bone levels are affected. A study conducted in South Africa demonstrated a significant correlation between the necrotizing diseases and the severe immune suppression in HIV patients. Neoplasms are the oral malignancies. The primary one is the Kaposi sarcoma caused by the human herpes virus 8. It appears as a red, purple macule or a nodule on the mass. 90% of them occur on the hard palate. It is seen among the homosexuals and bisexuals. The most severe form is the non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. It appears when the CD4 count falls below 100. It forms as a rapidly enlarging mass or ulcer on the palate or the gingiva. It has a very poor prognosis, even despite the treatment, with a lifespan of less than 1 year. Sjögren's syndrome. It is a salivary gland disorder. It is associated with the enlargement of the parotid gland. It causes reduced salivary flow. The patient complains of dry erythematous oral mucosa because of the lack of blood salivary flow. There is burning mouth and recurrent caries. A saliva consists of a lot of antimicrobial properties, and the lack of saliva can lead to the accumulation of microorganisms causing recurrent caries and periodontal diseases. HTLV type 1 disease is highly associated with Sjögren's syndrome, causing reduced salivary flow, periodontal disease, attachment loss, and the tooth loss. In a study conducted in our department, we tried to associate an association between CD4 counts and chronic inflammatory periodontal disease in 120 HIV-positive patients. CD4 counts were taken from the medical records. Periodontal disease measurements such as the plaque index, probing depth, clinical attachment loss were taken from the mesial aspect of the teeth. That's over here. There is a periodontal instrument that is inserted deep into the inflamed gum area. It causes the deeper the probe goes in, the higher the loss of bone. It's a correlation. CD4 counts versus plaque index. We could not find any statistical significance between the plaque index or the CD4 counts. CD4 counts related to the probing depth. CD4 counts versus probing depth, we could find a statistical significance about the probing depth. And CD4 counts with the clinical attachment loss, we could find a statistical significance about the level of immune suppression with the attachment loss of the bone loss around the tooth. This shows that the level of immunosuppression is associated with the progression of the periodontal disease or the oral lesions. So we try, the oral periodontal disease is basically due to the accumulation of microorganisms in the mouth. So microorganism accumulation is basically due to the lack of poor oral hygiene. So we try to determine an association between CD4 counts and oral hygiene in HIV-positive patients. That's a bar diagram showing the brushing frequency versus the CD4 counts. Out of 120 HIV patients, 84 patients brush their teeth once a day and 36 brush their teeth twice a day. We could find a statistical significance between them with a p-value of 0.01. We tried to associate the CD4 counts with the interdental aids. Interdental aids are basically the alternative form of oral hygiene measures that we try to keep our teeth clean. They are small interdental brushes, small brushes that we enter the small area of the tooth and keeps the teeth clean. We could find a statistical significance between the CD4 counts and the use of interdental aids. Only 26 of them use the interdental aids or other oral hygiene aids, and 94, the majority of them did not use any type of interdental aids. Conclusion, we could determine that the level of immunosuppression in HIV patients is associated with the poor oral hygiene, resulting in an accumulation of oral microorganisms, eventually leading to chronic periodontal disease. Some of the study, a recent study reported that low CD4 counts can be considered as a risk factor for the development of oral lesions, especially oral candidiasis. On the contrary to our study, there was a study reported where shows that no association between the periodontal disease and CD4 counts were found. Consequently, the microbial association of the HIV-associated periodontal disease are not thoroughly understood. Lack of oral hygiene and the CD4 counts below 400 reduce the ability of the host to control the infection by the periodontal pathogens, resulting in CIPD, that is the chronic inflammatory periodontal disease. Summary, oral health problems are common among the people infected with retroviral diseases. The higher the severity of the immune suppression, the rapid is the progression of the oral lesions. Patients must be encouraged to receive dental treatment at least every 6 months. Early identification of the oral conditions, prevention, diagnosis, and treatments must be emphasized. Thank you.